Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. Today, I will be analyzing the company of iFit Health & Fitness, which if everything goes as planned, it should be going public this upcoming October 5th, 2021 in the Nasdaq under the ticker symbol IFIT. As always, my aim with this video will be to go through the most relevant aspects, in my opinion, based on their SEC filing, which by the way, if you want to check it out yourselves, it will be linked down below in the description. And afterwards, if you enjoy the video, if you find the company interesting and maybe you would like to invest, you can go ahead and you should go ahead and do your own due diligence on that. Nevertheless, before I go into the analysis, let me quickly give you a short overview of the main topics that I will be covering today. Firstly, I will start with a general introduction to the company, and we will also look at some key metrics of the business. Followed by an analysis of the industry and competitors, this will be very short. Followed, as always, by the financials, and we will compare the financials of iFit with those of two other competitors, which will be Peloton and Nautilus. Then we will look into the IPO price and valuation, and we will compare the valuation again with the two competitors that I just mentioned now to see whether we would be getting a good deal or not. And finally, as always, I will be giving my personal opinion on the company and my future plans with it. With that said though, and after I remind you that if you enjoyed the video, it would be super awesome if you could give it a like, and please also consider subscribing if you want to see more IPO related videos of upcoming IPOs. But as I said, with that said, let's go for it. iFit Health & Fitness is a company operating within the fitness and health category, as the name already suggests, and they own several different brands, which most of them are just selling equipment, so fitness equipment like treadmills or static bicycles, but they also have one of the software that all of these machines that they sell has within it. And the different brands they own include iFit, which is the software, Nordic Track, Proform, FreeMotion, Vader, Veslo, and Sweat. And I won't go into the specifics of each brand, but especially within the part of manufacturing and selling the actual machines, they have it segmented. So within the different brands they own, they offer different price points and also quality of the products. And the best-selling one of all of these brands is actually Nordic Track, as you can see in the graph in the screen, with the revenues that come from each of these different brands. And to help us understand what exactly they sell the most in terms of products, you can see that it is mostly treadmills, followed by bikes, ellipticals, and subscription revenues. Also, it is the number one provider for large fitness equipment within the US, and they estimate that they have a market share of around 40%. And then moving into the software, the software brand, which as we mentioned, it's iFit, and it's mostly a platform for health and fitness. They currently have a community of 6.4 million members, 1.5 million subscribers from 120 different countries. And in terms of memberships, the individual one costs $15 per month, and then there's a family package of up to 5 family members that costs $39 per month. And iFit offers more than 17,000 interactive workouts, which include things like, for instance, going up to the Everest or cycling throughout the Alps. Of course, that's just what you see there on the screen and how the workout is set. But of course, they really work on the images that they show and to kind of like make it as real as possible. And finally, they also offer live and on-demand trainings, online trainings, of course, within 8 different languages. In terms of distribution of the products that they sell, they have a mix between direct-to-consumer and wholesale. For the fiscal year 2021, which ended just May this year, they had 44% sales from direct-to-consumer, and then 54% through 50 selected retailers globally, so wholesale, which these retailers include Amazon, Best Buy, or for instance, Decathlon, and then finally 2% through strategic partnerships. And from their total revenues, most of these were within the US and only 16% were international. Going into the industry, they consider their total addressable market to be valued at $3.1 trillion globally, which is massive, and within the US, they estimate that it is of $239 billion. In terms of commercial markets, so gyms or other facilities wanting to purchase their products, they estimate a global total addressable market of $36.7 billion, and in the US of $16.2 billion, which is certainly interesting. Within this massive industry though, they are of course not alone, and they face competition from several other players, including Peloton, Johnson Health Tech, Anta Sports, Techno Gym, Nautilus, and Core Health and Fitness, amongst others. But for the continuation of this video and for the comparison of the financials and evaluation, I will focus on Peloton and Nautilus because both of these companies are publicly traded and they also operate very similar business models to that of iFit, meaning that they both sell hardware but also software which is linked to the hardware. At this point though, let's go into the financials of iFit. And starting as always with revenues, we see that the progression during the past 3 years has been very positive with 21 and 104% year-over-year growth. Obviously, this last year was accentuated by people staying at home due to lockdowns and so on. But also, it is worth noting that firstly, their financial year goes from June to May each year. And secondly, that they made the acquisition of Sweat. And since they only closed this on June this year, the financials from Sweat are still not being reflected in the total of the company. And then looking at the numbers for the first quarter of their fiscal year 2022, which, by the way, there is a lot of seasonality in their business, and typically the second and third quarters of each fiscal year are much stronger as it's Christmas and so on. And taking the lower end of the estimations, we see that they will still be growing at least at 21% year over year. And then moving on the bottom line, this is not looking great, as although in 2019 they had reported profits, during the past 2 years the company has had massive losses, probably because they have focused a lot more on growth. And finally, on the balance sheet, as of May 31st this year, it looked horrible with a debt ratio of 168%, meaning that the company had more debt than assets, and this is very bad, as if something were to happen, even selling all the assets, they wouldn't be able to pay down all their current debt. The good thing though is that after this public offering, since they will be issuing more shares and paying down debt with the proceeds, the balance sheet is expected to look a lot better with a debt ratio of 83.1%. It is still a high ratio, but acceptable. If we now compare the financials of iFit with the two competitors, Peloton and Nautilus, we see that Peloton is the largest company, approximately 2 times larger than iFit, and it has experienced much more revenue growth than the other two. On the bottom line, both iFit and Peloton report losses, but Nautilus is profitable. And the net income margins, though, show that iFit seems to be the company that is farther away from reporting profits from all of them, while Peloton is likely to reach profitability this year or maybe next one. At this point, it is time to talk about the IPO price and valuation. And in terms of shares outstanding after the offering, I would like to stop for a second because after the offering, there will be 2 types of shares, Class A and Class B. The only difference between these two is that one Class B share will have 10 votes per share, while one Class A share will only have 1 vote. In terms of value of the shares, the value will remain the same. The only difference is on the voting power. And actually, all the Class B shares will be owned after the offering exclusively by the CEO and founder of the company, which in my eyes, it's very good because there is no one with better interest for the company than the person who founded it, because the company is kind of like its baby and no one will want it to succeed more than its founder. So that's something that I like. And actually, after this offering, the founder will own approximately 85.1% of the voting power of the company. So he will have full control over the decisions that the company makes. Going into the IPO price and with the information that we have available at the moment of preparing this video, this is expected to range between $18 to $21 per share. And taking the middle point of that, the amount of shares outstanding after the offering, including also possible conversion and also the sales for the past fiscal year, we have that iFit will start trading at a price to sales ratio of 3.57 times sales. This at first sight does not seem extremely expensive, but let's go and see the valuations of the competitors. On this, we have that Peloton is trading at 6.48 times sales and Nautilus at 0.53 times sales. So iFit is kind of in between. Personally, just looking at this, I think that iFit is at a sensible valuation with regards to its competitors. Peloton's revenues growth has been very similar, a bit higher than iFit, but they seem to be getting close to profitability, while iFit seems to be far away from it. And then Nautilus is trading much cheaper, but its revenue growth has been a bit irregular in the past, as well as its profitability. So just from the financials, I have not analyzed the company in depth, it is showing weakness, perhaps meaning that its products are not able to compete with the ones of Peloton or iFit, for instance. In all of this, what are my thoughts and will I be investing in its IPO? Well, personally, I will pass on this one, because leaving aside the fact that the valuation is not crazy expensive, and at least at the proposed IPO price, it looks pretty reasonable, I don't like at all the financials. They reported massive losses during the past year, actually during the past 2 years, and also the balance sheet before the IPO looked horrible. Yes, now after the IPO, it will get better and so on, but unless they manage to at least reduce these losses or reach profitability, the balance sheet will just keep getting worse as years go by. And this added to the fact that during the past year, with the lockdowns and everything, of course they had massive revenue growth, but my concern is that everyone who wanted to buy themselves a treadmill, static bicycle, and all of these things, they already did so during the past year. So my concern is whether they will be able to keep up the growth rate also moving forward. And with these basically two things, the financials and also the growth moving forward, which are a bit uncertain, I prefer to look at the IPO from the sidelines. Let's see how it starts trading, but for now I have no intentions of investing in it. Anyways, that's it for today. Please remember that everything I share in this video is based on my research, my calculations, and my opinion, which of course all of them could be wrong. I am no financial advisor, and you should always, always, always do your own due diligence before investing in this or any stock. With that said though, what are your thoughts on iFit Health and Fitness? Will you be investing in its IPO? Please let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, then don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel if you're not yet subscribed, and as always, see you next time.